games from Week 5. Copley's John Kramalik hits Brian Rinke on the move, makes a juggling catch, turns the corner, shakes three Highland defenders, and sprints 80 yards for the score. Number 7. It never gets old seeing this play from Week 9. St. Vincent St. Mary's Andrew Palla busts through the line and forces a fumble. Ohio State recruit Dante Booker scoops it up. 79 yards later, it's a sky score! Number 6, another defensive play, this time from Week 10. Aurora's Nolan Sotka watches, and then reacts, picking off the pass at the 2-yard line, and yes, he has reservations for 6. Number 5, how about a little trickeration in Week 8? Louisville's Connor Zwick runs left, pitches back to Andy Minster, who lets it fly, hitting a wide open Bryce Matthey, and the rest is history. Number 4. We've seen some offense, we've seen some defense. How about a little special teams action? Nordonia's Denzel Ward fields the punt, makes one man miss, then another. He's fast on the ground and from the air. Number 3. Another special teams play. Back to Week 6. Jeff Rotherman blocks the Bay field goal, and Brad Novak scoops it up and hits the Jets. That's a quarterback returning a blocked field goal for a touchdown. Number 2. In Week 8, we saw Aurora's Brian McNamara block Perry's Bryce Williams punt and then recover the ball in the end zone for a touchdown. Not bad for a defensive lineman. Drum roll, please. Number 1 comes to us from Week 7. Perry quarterback Jackson Birdieshaw throws to Jeremy Cook, who makes the perfect pitch to Brock Hurd. If you're keeping track at home, that's the old hook and ladder for a touchdown.